I'm JJ Chai. I'm a postdoc at NIMBioS. My background is in mathematics and statistics, and now my primary research interest is to use population genetics and phylogenetics to better understand the evolution. So phylogenetic studies the evolutionary history and the relation between different organisms. It uses different kinds of data, including molecular sequencing data, such as protein sequences and DNA sequences. And it also uses morphological data, such as body structure, eye color, and structure of wings of insects, and so on. And the relationship is described by a phylogeny. And the phylogeny, actually, it's just a tree, like the normal family tree, except all the nodes on the tree are different species in the world. And the branch length represent a much longer time. It could have a scale of million years. Why are we interested in the evolutionary history and the relationships between different species? And how does this benefit society? Well, there are many aspects in the answer to that question. It could help discover and identify new species. It could help the existing plants, crops, and animals. It could also help predict and control the disease outbreaks. And in the long run, predict human health. And the list goes on. Here is an example. Well, we all know how important corn is in our daily life and how valuable it is to continuously improve it. Well, phylogenetic knowledge helped trace the origin of the highly cultivated maize to 9,000 years ago of the highlands of Mexico, and also the genetic changes responsible for the highly modified corn cob. Well, scientists identified two Teosinte lineages as the closest relative of the cultivated maize, and also they identified the allele responsible for the cob. So the cultivated corn has the potential to interbreed with the different Teosinte grasses. So it is possible to incorporate some of new traits from those lineages to improve the existing corn crops. In addition, this study also showed how important it is to protect not only the wild species and the lineages of Teosinte grass, but also the inhabitants at the Mexico where they are found. Over the past decade, enormous progress has been made in the fields of genomics and information technology. That means more and more information in numerous databases worldwide is becoming available. So it is therefore important to manage, understand, and manipulate all these available information. In other words, we need better methods to analyze data to get more insight of the evolution processes. I expect that if we combine population genetics and phylogenetics, we can better understand the underlying nature of evolution, which hasn't been reviewed by either field separately. I'm currently working on a mathematical model of protein evolution that integrates population genetics and phylogenetics. We've already had some interesting findings under the model, which could help explain some intriguing behavior discovered earlier. I definitely hope that we can find more cool applications from the combination and interaction of these two fields.
For more information about postdoctoral fellowships at the National Institute for Mathematical and Biological Synthesis, visit our website at www.nimbus.org.